siblings. And now here's a story I can relate to because I went through it. When a grandparent gets memory loss or Alzheimer's, it really can scare away kids. Then they lose a valuable experience. So a new, very relaxed art program helps bring them together at the Children's Museum. Here to tell us more about this program is Angela Johnson, Arts Coordinator for Madison Children's Museum. I met her at the Alzheimer's Walk, and I was so touched by the program. What is SPARK? That's the name of the program. How does it work?
SPARK started from a Helen Bader Grant Foundation to 10 museums in both Minnesota and Wisconsin.
How does it work?
It is creative programming for adults in early stages of memory loss, a 90-minute program each month for children ages 7 and up, a parent, and grandparents in early stages of memory loss, looking at art prints, doing an art activity project. Everyone has an opportunity to create a story, tell their story, and come together.
I think the most important thing is they work as a team. The pictures that you had showed me is you see the grandparent and the younger child sitting together creating a drawing, talking about their experiences, because I know for a fact just trying to sit there with the grandparent who has Alzheimer's or in, you know, they're in the early stages of memory loss. You know, a child that's like 7 to 10 years old, they can't process that. So when they're sitting and creating pictures, kids already understand that.
Yes, that's very true. And with our move to the new building, working with underserved audiences, including grandparents with memory loss, seemed a natural extension to our new building to widen the range of audiences that we serve.
When are the programs offered and how much do they cost?
The programs are free and they're offered once a month on selected Saturdays. For more information to find out about our programming, we have an informational session today, October 19th, at the museum. People who are interested can just come and sign in. And we'll give a guided tour of the museum, do a condensed version of the program, and answer any questions.
You know, and I think that's a great idea. Even if you don't bring that grandparent by, usually the child of the grandparent knows what they can handle. And it's great to be able to get there, see what happens. If you've never been to the Children's Museum, Charlie and I broadcasted live there from about, about a month, maybe 6 weeks ago. It is tremendous, the facility. I think anyway would be really neat for that grandparent to get out and see it, and also for the younger generation. As a child, I remember when I was a cheerleader, back in the day, the pom-poms came all together. So my parents took me over to my grandmother's who had Alzheimer's, and we just peeled away every single layer of pom-poms, listened to music, and to this day, I still remember that as just a golden memory I had with her. So it was a way that we could relate. It was a way that I didn't feel scared or uncomfortable. But if I had something like this, an art program where I'm there with my parents and my grandparents in a colorful environment, I think that's a beautiful thing.
Yes, we're very excited about it. And to piggyback off what you said, we incorporate all five senses, and there's always a takeaway memento to extend the experience.
Oh, I think that's great. So, informational meeting today for free. For more information, you can go right to our web channel, nbc15.com. Thank you so much, Angela. We appreciate what you're doing for all three generations in a